MegaFacts presents a short video about the disappearance of the Megalodon. Despite our fascination with this enormous, extinct relative of today's great white shark, there's still a great deal we don't know about the life and death of the biggest shark that ever lived. For starters, we still don't know why the last of the megatooths died over 2.5 million years ago. In the entire history of cartilaginous fish, Carcharoctles megalodon was a huge success story. And that's not just because of the predator's size and inferred ferocity. This species patrolled the coasts of the Atlantic, Pacific, and Indian Oceans for about 20 million years. Few creatures can claim such a record. And that only makes the disappearance of the shark all the more puzzling. Changes brought on by a cooling climate have been the focus of the traditional explanation for the monstrous shark's demise. Megalodon has often been thought of as a warm water hunter, and so, the argument goes, as sea temperatures dipped at the end of the Pliocene, the whales, seals, and other fatty mammals the shark relied upon migrated to chilled seas where the shark couldn't follow. The pitiful silichin was simply left behind as cetaceans spouted off for the poles. But was the great shark so restricted by temperature? To find out, paleontologist Catalina Pimiento and colleagues drew from the paleobiology database to analyze occurrences of the megalodon over time in relation to climate. Contrary to what had previously been thought, temperature probably didn't freeze the shark into extinction. The big picture looks something like this. During the shark's early years, around 20 million years ago, megalodons primarily swam through waters of the northern hemisphere. Populations expanded around 15 million years ago to include every major ocean basin on the planet. The research is right, but from there the shark's population steadily declined. All of this happened irrespective of climate. During times of major temperature spikes and dips, megalodon occurrences didn't seem to show any direct response. Not to mention that the shark seemed fully capable of coping with a range of temperatures from 53 to 80 degrees Fahrenheit, and there have been waters in this range from the shark's time until today. So if it wasn't cooler waters, what drove the shark to extinction? There's still no definitive answer. Even today, when we can witness species disappear, it's often difficult to precisely retrace the road from the vanishing point back to the first signs of trouble. In the case of the megalodon, though, we have some ideas about possible kill switches. Through hindsight, we can see that the road to extinction for the megatooth shark started in the middle of the Miocene. This coincided with two major events, as previously pointed out by paleontologist Dana Ahut as well as the authors of the new study. Against a background of crashing whale diversity during this time, the world saw the evolution of some stiff competition for the megalodon, large sharks close to the ancestry of the great white and sperm whales that behaved and hunted more like today's orcas. This trend continued only through the Pliocene, with fewer big baleen whales and an increasing array of predators that young megatooth sharks would have struggled against to get enough food down their throats. There was less food to go around for an expanding guild of predators who relied upon warm, blubbery prey. The case isn't closed yet, though. So much of what's known about the megalodon comes from teeth, the occasional vertebra, and some bite marks. Those pieces only reach so far in revealing the massive shark's biology, including how much the fish actually relied on filter-feeding whales for food or the other predators it was striving against to survive. We can be sure the megatooth shark is dead. The fish's fossil record taps out by 2.5 million years ago, and we surely wouldn't miss populations of 50-foot-long sharks patrolling the global coastlines. But why the shark vanished is a secret still waiting to be dredged from the fossil record. Hope you enjoyed the video and don't forget to subscribe to our channel and check our other content as well.